lovely space cadet. So my name is Elise, and I will be one of your hosts today, alongside pilot Tom, who's all the way in the back. Tom, can you raise your hand for me? Tom! He's over there in the pilot suit. All right. So if you, just so you guys know, Mayor Tom is going to be leading you all over the ship today. Now, can anybody tell me what ship this is called? Where are we?
INTREPID,
and it has a very specific military name. Anybody know what kind of ship it is? It's an aircraft carrier. Now, does anybody know what an aircraft carrier is? What is it?
It carries planes.
It does. It carries planes. It's like a big airport that can float on the water. Pretty cool, right? Now, this specific one is actually almost 1,000 feet long. That means it's almost the size of the Chrysler building. That being said, there are many of you and only two of us, and we don't want to get lost. So make sure you follow us when we go walk around this ship. Can you guys do that?
Yeah.
Now, this is the most important question. Why are we here today?
Celebrate Dimitri's birthday.
We are. Celebrating Dimitri's birthday party. Can I get a round of applause for his birthday? Alright, how old are you turning? 78. I'm gonna ask you a lot of questions. So if you ask it, if you have a comment or an answer, are you gonna raise your hand or shout it out? Yeah, we all like roller coasters, don't we? And parents, you can listen to this as well. So our first stop is going to be the XD simulator. That's like a roller coaster in space. Everybody follow Demetrius and Tom for me.
We'll be right back.
high-speed camera. Get you to do this.
What are you here for?
Demetrius! Come over here!
Kevin!
So does anyone know the name of this plane?
Is that yours?
It's the Blackbird, right?
Is it yours?
So this one's not my plane, no. But this is a spy plane. This is a spy plane. So that means that this plane would fly around and it would spy on the people on the ground.
Why?
So have any of you ever been on a plane before?
Not me.
When you looked at the plane, what did you see? You saw things like clouds. Maybe you saw the ground below you, right?
Yes. Yeah.
When the pilot of this plane was flying, he saw space. He flew at 90,000 feet.
Off the ground?
Off the
ground. No!
That's impossible!
It's totally impossible. The plane that you guys would have been on would have only been around 30,000 feet. So he flew three times higher than you did.
And where is the stratosphere?
So it's still higher than that, but we're working our way to the, like, the end of space. Plane flew three times faster than the speed of sound. So as fast as my voice is reaching your ears, it flew
We have a really cool story about how fast this plane went, but first it involved a little surprise.
So everyone, to your hands.
They're getting warm.
They're getting warm, right? Does anyone know why that happens? You know why that happens? It's rubbing, it's called friction. So when things rub together, they get hot. It's called friction.
Because it's traveling so fast, it's when the air pushes it to 1,000 degrees.
See the cockpit window up there? That gets up to 600 degrees. So like I said, the pilot of this plane, he loved grilled cheese sandwiches. So one day while he was at base,
It's like an oven
in there, exactly right. So one day while he was at base, he took a piece of cheese, put it between two pieces of bread, and he snuck it inside of his flight suit. While he was in the air, he took it out, he held it up to the window, and he was able to cook his grilled cheese sandwich in 45 seconds.
Wow.
Has anyone here ever had a grilled cheese sandwich at the end of space?
Once again, guys, please find where you're stepping, as there are some puddles and some holes that you don't want to trip on.
Yeah.
We gotta go inside of
here. Everybody, can you guys put your listening ears on?
Yes!
Are you guys, can you guys hear me?
Yeah.
All right, so we're about to go inside this gated area. Like I said, please mind where you step. There are some divots that you can trip over. So please don't trip over there. Okay. We do have one important role inside the helicopter. You will see buttons. Press them. If it says do not press, press it anyways. This is the one time you can do this. If you see a basket, get in it. If you see a radio, talk on it. Any levers you see, pull it. Can you guys do that for me?
Yes!
All right, you also have the ability to go sit inside the cockpit, which is where the pilots flew this. Yay. It's only two at a time, so you guys are gonna line up inside the helicopter. Can you guys do that for me?
Yes!
All right, Karen, did you wanna stay outside the helicopter? This is a great time for photos.
Yeah.
And Karen, mind your head.
Gone. Now we die, spouting a flame from under. Off with
as many as you could. Did you try to take off?
Huh?
Did you try to take off in the helicopter? Did you try to?
Well, I wanted to. I think it was moving.
You thought it was moving? Maybe. You might have gotten it off.
Probably forgot to put gas in, huh?
Yeah, we might need. That might be the problem. We might need a little bit of gas. We might need to put some more gas in.
It's the Enterprise! So this guy is called the Enterprise. You can see it right over there. Now, how many of you think this guy went into space? How many of you don't think he went into space? How many of you don't know at all? That's not bad. So this guy actually never went into space. It doesn't even have an engine. So why do we have it? Have you guys made a paper airplane before?
Yeah!
Yeah, we've all made paper airplanes. So this is basically a glorified paper airplane. Actually, only 7 people would fit in this space shuttle. You see where that says Enterprise? That's the only place the astronauts could live. Everything else was like a big U-Haul truck. Now I have a very important question for you. Are you guys listening?
Yes.
Who's hungry? Yeah, you all are hungry, so our next step is actually going to go down to our party room
awesome.
To be able to eat food as well as some cake.
Pizza.
Are you guys ready?
Yeah, we're ready.
This is going to be the last place, so we're going to go back outside in that snow. You're going to follow, we're going to follow Tom all the way back down to that party
room. We would like you to come right straight to eat and hold that heading for lunch.
Technology. Where can you begin to make your dreams all come true? can sail the seven seas.
It's the Navy.
Yes, you can put your mind at ease.
It's the Navy.
Come on, people, and make a stand.
It's the Navy.
Can't you see we need a hand?
It's the Navy.
Come on, protect the motherland.
It's the Navy.
Come on and join your fellow men.
Not have a David Wood.